This is actually really fucking stupid.
Yeah.
But I gotta text him too, but
I'm about to give $980 in cash.
So somebody can come pick that up and drop it off at your house tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
What could possibly go wrong? It's a Z31 300ZX.
Don't forget it's, the turbo and 50-year anniversary, baby.
How could you forget? It says it right there. That means it's fast, bro. Getting it for $800 is such a fucking steal. I mean, it's like in mint condition. Look at that.
Hey, there's a rat in there. Nice.
Oh, really?
Hint.
Oh!
Holy shit.
I didn't even see that before.
Oh, yeah, that's, that's definitely seen better days.
Yo, this guy's got a living room in here. I don't even know how we're gonna
on the next
push this thing.
Quarters.
And so it's $800 though, that's the thing. So like, what am I, oh my god, how am I gonna do the bill of sale, dude? I don't even know where the VIN is on this thing.
So basically, I had to get one of my cars smogged and I noticed this 300 in the parking lot at the smog check. I asked the owner of the shop about it and he told me he had been trying to sell it for months because some guy had just left it on his property and never came back for it. Said that there is some type of engine issue and the previous owner was trying to fix it, which explains why the downpipe and transmission were sitting in the trunk of the car.
I'm good, how are you?
The owner of the shop told me that it would be about $800 for the car and another $160 to tow the car to my friend's garage about 40 minutes away. Since I had been looking for a shell to build out into a drift or circuit racing car, I was still pretty interested, despite the fact that the transmission was in the trunk and the license plate had 2012 stickers. The only thing was that the windshield had been smashed on the driver's side, and so the hole that usually displays the VIN was obstructed by smashed glass. Since I didn't have the VIN, I couldn't actually complete the bill of sale, and because of that, I was a bit nervous that the car wouldn't actually end up showing. But the owner of the shop was friendly and seemed trustworthy, so I just decided to pull the trigger.
So we just gave Arturo the money. Fingers crossed, hopefully the car actually shows up tomorrow, otherwise I'm gonna be out almost a grand, but I got a bill of sale with no VIN number because we couldn't find it, whatever that's worth.
We're at the homies. Mom's house, actually, because neither of us have a garage.
It's just LA lifestyle, I guess.
Has he texted you yet?
Nope.
No? All right. Well, I mean, that's a great sign.
At least I have something to do while we wait.
This Cayenne is supposed to be my tow rig, but I literally just got it. So I haven't done any of the regular maintenance yet. It's also missing a trailer pins, even though it's rated to tow like 8,000 pounds. I guess they figured their target of soccer moms weren't ever really going to be towing track cars around, but it is what it is.
So it's just dead weight, it's not like neutral weight.
Especially fighting.
If you were like all maturity fighters.
So, because even if you're rich, you'd want to not have CTE.
Exactly.
Yeah, those are the type of kids that.
Arturo's giving me a call.
Oh, the tow truck's here?
Yeah. Talk to him. His name is Miguel. He's
okay.
There.
Hey, let's go.
Yeah. All right.
I think he's right there, actually. Shit. Hi. Is it okay if I like record?
So
it's actually here, dude.
It's actually here, man.
There he goes to O'Reilly, cause this rolls under its own power, but we didn't realize that the steering was completely locked, so we're picking up some car dollies so we can stuff them under the front two wheels and get it put into this garage and get it out of everybody's way. We definitely pissed some people off bringing this in. The tow truck was not exactly quiet. So we weren't exactly able to get a look at it before either, because it was on the ground, but I mean, there's a ton of rust here. That looks like, honestly, it's been in an accident of some sort. Yeah, that's actually some pretty gnarly rust over there too. I don't think there's anything that's unrepairable, at least.
Works out.
Oh, shit. Take two. Nature's tripod, the Ford Mustang.
Tell me when to start.
I'm pushing.
Fuck a bitch, I don't trust no bitch with my government. Fuck a friend, I don't want no friends with no open hands. Count my bands all alone at home, don't you call my phone. Everyone that I ever known ask me for a loan. Leave me alone, 44 Stallone, get that nigga gone. Raging boy, this not paid in full, but I kill my own. Yes, I love you cause you black, but don't love your ass like that. I will put you on a shirt if you fuck me out my racks. Cherry app, down the app, hold you ass. Average. Louis bag, Gucci bag, you got baggage. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. I will never give my money to a bad bitch. Derry Ave, Locust Ave, ho, you average. Birkin bag, Chloe bag, you got baggage. You will never catch me slipping out in traffic. You will never catch me slipping out in traffic. AMGs and SMGs, I'm in a dash shit. Ay. Wasn't what he thought, we called him like a catfish.
It's finally in the garage. Next step is stripping the frame, getting it prepped to refresh, because this has definitely seen better days. But thankfully the previous owner took out, or at least started, a lot of the stripping process, so it shouldn't be too long. There's no end fuck we're doing that today.